tonight.
What we're going to do right now is we're going to focus on the governor's race. And so we invited both the state Republican Party chairman and the state Democratic Party chairman into our studios. GOP Chairman Reince Priebus decided to join us live from Scott Walker's campaign. Mike Tate is in our newsroom tonight, the Democratic Party chair. And good evening to both of you. Let's talk about the governor's race, because the primary still hasn't been decided. We're not going to project anything at this hour. So let me ask you about the consequences of this primary for both of your parties. Reince Priebus, has it been a good thing for the Republican Party?
Well, I think it's been a great process. You know, we've got a lot of momentum, and, you know, clearly I think the people of Wisconsin are tired of out-of-control spending, out-of-control debt, a government that's about to walk off a fiscal cliff. All the energy is on the Republican side of the aisle. No matter what happens tonight, we're going to be unified tomorrow. And really, we're going to defeat Tom Barrett, because that's the message that the people of Wisconsin want: lower taxes, less spending, and getting this government under control. And that momentum's with us. We are the story tonight. We've been the story through the whole summer. And those messages are going to resonate all the way to November.
Mike Tate, are they the story tonight? Is that momentum going to continue into November? What do you do to stop it?
Well, look, you know, the last public poll on this Republican governor's race had Scott Walker with a 41-point lead. We don't know if he's going to win or lose tonight, but it's safe to say it's going to be very close. I think that we're seeing Scott Walker, if he comes out of this race, as a severely weakened candidate. He can't have very much money left over. And I think that voters have really seen Scott, started to see who Scott Walker, for who he is. He's a flip-flopper. He does, is a terrible budgeter. He's raised spending more than Jim Doyle has as governor. And I think that the more voters learn about Scott Walker, the more they dislike. And I think we're starting to see that in the primary results tonight.
You sound like you think Scott Walker is going to be the winner tonight. That's what it sounds like.
You know, I'll leave it to Reince to predict who's going to be the Republican Party nominee. The guy had a 41-point lead in the last published poll. I mean, he should win. He might squeak it out. He might not. Look, we're ready to take on whoever wins tonight, whether it's Scott Walker or Mark Newman. And we're looking forward to the fall campaign.
Reince Priebus, how much money is Scott Walker going to have left after tonight? How much money will he have left after tonight for the race this fall? How much money is he going to have to raise?
Well, first of all, the reason I'm laughing is because I love how, Mike, you just keep pounding on Scott Walker. You're just on a one-track mind there, buddy. keep it coming. I don't think money is going to be an issue no matter what happens tonight. Wisconsin is going to be ground zero in this country. There's no doubt about it. I think Mike would agree. Other than maybe Ohio, you could make a case that Wisconsin and Ohio is ground zero for the country. We're a microcosm of the country. No one's going to go down for lack of money. There'll be plenty of money. People are invested. These are important issues of people. Spending, debt, jobs, those are the issues. Republicans win in November on those issues. But there'll be plenty of money to go around, Mike.
I think
does matter. I mean, we've seen Scott Walker can't manage money as a county executive. He can't manage money as a candidate. Tom Barrett, in the last public information we had an over a 2-to-1 lead in cash on hand. And I think what that speaks to is Tom's got serious adult experience in running the city. And Scott Walker, frankly, can't manage the county, can't manage his campaign.
All right, well, we're going to have leave it right there. I know this conversation could continue all night, and we'll invite you back again
soon. You know that, Mike.
All right, guys, thanks very much. And did I say we still haven't projected a winner in this race? It just may sound that way from listening to the two of them. We'll be back with more a little bit later on.
This could go on all night, too, because, you know, the results continue to come in.